Yes, I was very pleased that he was captured and brought to trial, and I felt that it was a symbolic act for standing for what the Germans, what the Nazis did to the Jews. While in Israel there was no death penalty, Eichmann was killed. And while I'm not in favor of the death penalty, but in that case I think it is, I had no opinion. While I'm not in favor of kidnapping somebody, in that situation I also had really no particular aversion to what the Jews did to Eichmann. And I thought it was rather kind of uncanny that Eichmann, who decided on our fate, whether we were supposed to live or die, when he interviewed us, my sister was made a witness at his trial, and she did not single-handedly decided about his fate, but still she contributed to the decision. Yes, she was a witness at his trial and was interviewed, and it was exceedingly peculiar for me to watch her on television. I was here and she was there. And when I now reread and rethink her the situation, reread her letter, I think I should have been there with her. But I wasn't. I was working and I had a commitment. And I came to the trial while it was still going on. I didn't hear her. I watched her always on television. It was always televised. But still, I then went to see her as soon as I could. And really experienced this great moment. That Eichmann was vindicated, so to speak. Not really vindicated because we lost so many Jews, but still.